2011 ended up to be a highly volatile time in the market, yet a very successful year for IPOs. We saw successful offerings from technology issuers such as Fusion.io and LinkedIn in the social networking space. And then we ended the year with a very successful consumer-oriented transaction in Michael Kors. 2011 also saw issuance from countries around the world. Actually, nearly seven countries issued stock here in the U.S. in initial public offerings this year. This continued a global trend of issuance from around the world coming to the U.S. to access the deepest pool of liquidity anywhere in the world, as well as providing deal execution certainty amidst an environment of high uncertainty around the rest of the world. In the technology sector, we continue to see great excitement from investors, particularly around social media and in infrastructure, media, and internet, certainly highlighted by offerings such as Pandora Media and in LinkedIn, setting up further excitement for more deals in this sector to continue. With over 120 transactions and nearly $30 billion in filed pipeline, we see a significant opportunity for more initial public offerings in 2012. We see sectors such as technology, financials, consumer, energy, and real estate being the leading sectors for 2012. We also expect the coming years to see more issuance from companies from other countries around the world. In Europe, Latin America, and in Asia, we'll continue to see a significant amount of issuance activity here in the United States. So in 2012, we continue to be quite bullish on the market opportunities as long as we have certainty around the markets, as long as we're able to see reduced volatility, as well as more certainty around global geopolitics. Advocacy on behalf of our listed companies continues to be an important part of the NYSE Euronext value proposition. We continue to support opportunities for young, emerging growth companies to come to the market. Providing an efficient access to the public markets is important for small and medium-sized enterprises. 92% of a company's growth comes after the initial public offering. So having a regulatory environment that supports access to capital helps foster an important job engine for the U.S. as well as the global economy. So 2011 ended up to be a tumultuous year for the market, but a successful year for IPOs. As we look at our backlog, we're quite optimistic about what 2012 can bring. And so we continue to believe that the value proposition on NYSE Euronext remains access to the largest global market of issuers from around the world, access to the largest pool of liquidity, and leveraging the branding and visibility that comes from the most unique trading platform of anywhere in the world.